Of that historic win for the U.S. was 20-year-old goalkeeper Tony Meola, a student at the University of Virginia. Meola posted his fourth straight shutout of the World Cup qualifying cycle in that game, whilst winning just his seventh cap. His remarkable football career includes starting at the 1990 and 1994 World Cups and being a backup at the 2002 World Cup. He won 100 caps for the U.S. and he posted 32 shutouts. In 2012, he was elected to the U.S. Soccer Hall of Fame. Amongst all his many accomplishments, that epic game in Trinidad and his Italian heritage is something that Tony never forgets.
Hey, look who I found. How are you?
Good to see you, buddy.
Great to see you.
This was a town where you were first cool if you played soccer, which is very different from probably 99% of the places around the U.S. at that time. There's these little training pitches all around the town, and I don't know who else had that. I would imagine at the time we were growing up, St. Louis was still a soccer hotbed, but growing up here in Kearney, I don't, none of us even knew where St. Louis was at the time. As kids, we had a love for the game, and you wanted to play for the Scots Club. This was it. When you were here, you knew you had a chance to win a state championship every year. You had a chance to play in the regionals. And
this must be the important side of the field.
TV guy.
You know, eventually getting to high school.
Mr. Miller, how you doing, man?
And playing for John Miller and getting the black jacket with the white sleeves with your numbers and your position and the year you won the state championship. Like, that was cool. But kind of just goes along with the heritage of this place.
Give me a hug. How you doing?
I mean, I walked in this building, I got chills, to be honest. I thought of myself as a 10-year-old with my dad pulling up behind the building. And my dad used to joke all the time because there weren't a lot of Italians in this place. They just didn't come in the Scots Club all that much. Plus, he used to say, oh, the pasta's no good in there, you know? The pasta's no good in here. But everyone's parents grew up in Europe, and we were all first generation here.
Well, joining us now is the last line of defense for the United States on that memorable day in Trinidad, U.S. Soccer Hall of Famer Tony Meola. Good to see you. Good to have you with us for the first time in the studio. I guess we're just all interested
in
your experience of that game. What was it? What do you remember?
Oh, boy, Kate, and good to see all of you guys. I enjoy watching you guys every other week. You fascinate me with different stuff every week. But, Kate, going back to Trinidad, it is amazing. First off, it's amazing that this story was finally told. We're in 2023, and the group that got to the World Cup for the first time in 50 years, we're just kind of hearing about it. We didn't grow up in the social media era. We didn't grow up in, you know, the internet was big where you could find things. I mean, this is, you're talking about 1989, and to go back and relive the memories. I remember red. That's what I remember for 3 or 4 days. And JP Del Camera, who's prominent in the documentary, talks about when we got down to Trinidad, people were painting their houses red. They had declared a national holiday. And I just remember 20-year-old bunch of young kids. I mean, I was a 20-year-old punk thinking that we could conquer the world. And I'm more nervous now watching the video, even after the result, than I was back then. But I just remember the conversations about let's do something that hasn't been done in 40 years. And that's never an easy thing to do. It's a little bit easier now. And we didn't grow up, you know, Thierry Henry in France and Mike and Jamie and growing up in the UK and having this heritage. They kind of inherently grow up with this background in the sport. We didn't have that. We were trying to create a background and a history in our sport. And it had been gone for quite some time. So I thought the documentary did a really good job of grasping the entire story.
Tony, you're a legendary goalkeeper for the States, but there's been a great tradition of goalkeepers from America coming over to England. I played with one, Brad Friedel. You also had a little stint at a couple of clubs, namely Brighton, who were doing so well at the moment. Why do you think that was?
Well, Yeah, well, obviously everyone looks at the athletic part of the goalkeeping, right? All of us grew up, whether it was Tim Howard, whether it's Brad Friedel, Casey Keller, we all grew up playing basketball and other sports here. And, you know, athletically, I always thought we can compete, you know, and I hope in a lot of ways that I started to open some doors. Jamie, I fought for a work permit every Monday trying to get one, and I was determined to stay in Europe until they told me I couldn't stay in Europe anymore. It was a dream, and we just, guys like John Harkes and Paul Caligiuri and Tom Ramos going to Spain, you know, I heard you guys' conversation down in Miami about sort of respect for players, and I certainly think it's changed now. I think the American players are respected, they're given the opportunities, and then you've got to go and earn it. I agree with everything you guys said, but back then, you really didn't even get the chance. It was so difficult. And so we needed to do something special in the U.S. And that was get to a World Cup in this case. But we've been blessed with goalkeepers. You named, you know, you talked about Brad Friedel. I mean, he was incredible. How long he played, the longevity, Tim Howard, Casey Keller prior to him. It's been a pretty good line. And now Matt Turner, obviously, playing there as well and trying to make his way. So it's been fun to be part of that history.
Tony, I know you love the show, but who's your favorite? Are you going with Kate, the presenter, or one of us three pundits?
Well, I learned by watching the show, it is now should be called Kate, Thierry, and the Sidekicks, right? Because he's the original.
Is that what it is? The Sidekicks.
After that build-up, I give you the legend, goalkeeper.
Tony, with
listen,
that, you are...
I love you guys, man. I honestly got to watch you like everybody else. And by the way, so important what you guys do, because we still need to continue to grow the game. So what you guys do here is just another step in growing the game in the U.S. So really, really appreciate it from somebody who was there in the dark days, if you will.
Oh, with that kind of answer, you are very welcome anytime on the show. Thank you, Tony. Good to see you, man.